Hey guys, it's Brandon here from Desk Punch Games. Today we're going to be making a pegboard game, also known as Plinko or Pachinko, whatever you want to call it, in just 5 minutes. Let's get started. Okay, so first, we are going to make a few squares. We're going to turn them into rectangles. And we're going to duplicate this. And we're going to make it really tiny because we want to separate the zones, the point zones, I guess you could call them. Now we need to make a bunch of triangles. We want 6 of them probably. Change the color so it's a little bit different. It's not all just the same and awkward looking. Not that this looks great or anything, but it's from scratch. It's fine. And then we can just make this circle real quick and we'll change. That'll be our ball for whatever is supposed to be used for Plinko. And then we're gonna make another circle. We'll rename this ball real quick to differentiate, and it would help to spell it right. Okay, now let's just make this circle smaller, but a bit bigger than the ball is. We'll just put this at negative 0.75, and then we'll just do the same thing we did with the rectangles down below. We'll just add or subtract 1.5 on each one. I would have just made some folders right at the start instead of the mess over there. That's just too much stuff. And we'll change the color of these instead of just basic white. White actually looked better, but whatever, we're just trying to hurry. We're good. And now we can get our UI element, which is just going to be the points at the bottom. And that for that, we will use TextMesh Pro. First, we're going to edit the canvas. Let's get this to the top, actually. Okay, so we're going to edit the canvas first. We want it to scale with screen size, and we're going to make that 1920 by 1080. It's just standard 1080p. And then we also need to make the screen space like it's coming from the camera. We don't want the overlay for this. We need to drag the main camera over, and we want the order in layer to be 1. If we don't do that, then the points are just going to not be visible. Alright, so let's go into our text and we're going to put in all the points real quick. Replace it. UI can be kind of messy to work with, so that's why we did all that stuff beforehand with the canvas. It makes it much easier to work with. Let's change the text to just black. We'll also make it bold so it sticks out more. Okay, so now that the points look good and the game views look good, we need to add some stuff to our ball. We need to make a rigid body 2D. Make sure you don't do the regular, it's for 3D only. Then we want to do a circle collider. In a small game like this, you could use pretty much any collider as long as it fits the shape. And then we're going to add a 2D physics material. We're just going to name this Bounce. We're going to just drag it over onto the ball. It'll show over here in the circle collider. So just click on that and friction's at 0.4. That should be good. And the bounciness, let's do 0.7. All right, that should be good. Let's move the ball up here, get it out of the way. Select everything real quick, and then we're going to add just do polygon collider for the sake of being faster. Not efficient for the engine, but faster for us. And then we need a C# script, and this is the last thing we need to do pretty much. We're going to call it random spawn. Let's go into there and we're going to start putting some code in here. There's really not much to this. If you're new to code, this might seem a little complicated, but it's really very simple, and I'll explain it to you a little bit. We want a vector 2 because we're going to want the x and y axis. So we're going to just call this random position, and that is going to be the xy coordinates of the ball. So we need two public floats now. Let's do x range, and we'll just set that to 5f. And then we'll do y range and set that to 0.5f. Float, just call this x position, equals random.range. So the range we're going to use is 0 minus the x range, which we set to 5. So just 0 minus 5, negative 5. And 0 plus x range is 5. So the range is just negative 5 to 5. Really simple. And for the y position, we will do the same basic thing, but we're going to change this 0 to whatever the ball is at right now. Okay, and then we have random position. We're going to set that to a new vector 2, which is the random numbers that we just generated. So then we want transform.position. So we want the transform of our object, and the position is just the coordinates of it. So that'll put the generated coordinates into the ball's transform so that it'll actually move the ball to the random spot. And in update, we can add if input.getKey. For this, we'll just use the space bar. So that's just saying it's waiting for the player to hit the space bar, and then it will do whatever we say in here. Let's just tell it to do scene manager.load scene 0, and that'll just reset the scene. We only have the one scene, and it starts at 0, and then it goes 1, 2, 3, whatever. After that, first scene is always 0. We're just loading the very first scene, and it's basically just restarting the game. Okay, well, with that done, we can actually try the game now and see how it works. Alright, looking good so far. Nice. Oh, okay, 10,000 on the first go. Nice. Let's hit the space bar and see what it does. Nice, okay. Didn't spawn in the same exact spot. Moved over a little bit that time. Yeah, and every time you hit it, it just resets. Really quick and easy to test that. And it's just going all over the place. Perfect, that's exactly what we wanted. And of course, this could be fine-tuned pretty heavily. And you could improve upon it a ton, obviously. I mean, it's a 5-minute game. Of course you can improve it. And yeah, I definitely messed up a lot while recording this. Going fast like this takes a lot of practice. It's sort of like speedrunning a game. You have to practice it over and over and over. I have not done that. So I could probably do this way faster if I just practiced it. I'm sure you can too. And now if you want to make a very basic game and you have never done it, try this out. The perfect way to get started, and there are plenty of tutorials just like this that you can find online. I'll probably be doing more of these on the channel. There are also a lot of little tricks and shortcuts you could use to make this much faster than it already is, even with no practice. If you just know the shortcuts and everything, it's going to be so much faster. And if you do know any of those little shortcuts or tricks, let us know in the comments. Hey, thanks for watching. If you want to help me go full-time, subscribing goes a long way. I appreciate you, and I'll see you next time.